The Chinese Riddler has come out with new information explaining the riddles and giving us more clues as to what we could expect in Pokemon Legends Arceus. Let's break it down. Yo, what is going on YouTube? It's your boy Dan, aka Driver, bringing you guys a brand new video today. And today we are diving into the Chinese Riddler, a well-known historic figure in the Pokemon League community who has actually just come out last night on Twitter with a ton of information regarding their most recent riddle and actually basically just completely shattering Centro, saying they stole this picture from me and I'm not having it. I'm gonna give you guys the rundown. So y'all better get your popcorn ready because it is about to go down. I took a lot of notes. I did a lot of digging on the internet to try to solve some of these riddles and some of these clues. I think we've got some really, really good stuff here. I hope you guys enjoy it. So hit that like button down below if you guys do. And of course, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new. And just for full disclosure, these are rumors. While I do think that this Chinese Riddler has some pretty cool stuff going on, and it's likely that a lot of this does come to fruition, just keep your hopes in check and understand that this is for discussion and rumor purposes, and that at this point, this stuff is not 100% confirmed. So just keep that in mind. But without further ado, man, we got some things to jump into. And by the way, if you haven't pre-ordered Pokemon Legends Arceus or Brilliant Diamond Shining Pearl yet, you could do so with my link in the description below at Best Buy. You can actually pick up a copy of BDSP, the double pack, and get the awesome keychain, or Legends Arceus and get those pre-order bonuses like the kimono and, of course, the heavy balls. And with BDSP, you won't miss out on the Manaphy egg. So check out the link in the description. It helps me out a ton. Seriously, it helps out a lot. So go pre-order if you haven't. Okay, so here's the post from the Chinese Riddler saying, Central stole this pick from me. I'm gonna break them all down. And I have to say, they are all based on Japanese puns and culture with a little bit of Asian stuff. However, the thief, Centro, put it out in the English community, how stupid and ridiculous that was. So basically, this Riddler is saying, listen, I made this for the Asian community. This wasn't meant to be shared amongst the English community because they're not going to understand it. The puns and the context of these different images really only make sense in this culture. So for everyone else, it's going to be very confusing, and it seems that the Riddler was a little bit upset or frustrated at the fact that Centro is posing to basically say that that was theirs. So I think at this point we can really write off anything Centro says because they seem to be stealing other people's content and leaks and riddles and things of that nature. But they number all of the pictures, obviously, that we've seen from this riddle of these 12 different potential Pokemon forms, and they actually give little hints to each one of them, and that is where I'm gonna break all this down right now for you guys. So the first one, this is a yokai from Yokai Watch. Her Japanese name is The Key. Once you know it, you will understand all about this mon. Now, some of these statements I'm gonna make are actually from the Riddler, because the Riddler actually went through the thread and commented on each single one. So this particular yokai from Yokai Watch, and you're gonna have to, you know, bear with me on some of this pronunciation, but is Hayaki Hime. They use ice and dark slash ghost powers in Yokai Watch anime, and they're said to gather many souls. So there's a potential connection here with the 100 Demon Princess. It's got this soul element to it of capturing souls. So there's a lot of speculation around Spirit Tomb, but a lot of people are saying that this actually ties to one of the starters, and thus it is actually representation of Typhlosion's secondary typing becoming ghost type, which kind of aligns with some of the other stuff we've seen from Ball Guy leaks and some of these other sources. So there's a couple different angles that number one can take, one of which is some sort of tie to a new form of Spirit Tomb, but I think more realistically it's actually tying into the typing, which is the ghost powers, and how that ties to Typhlosion. But again, the hint from the Riddler is that her Japanese name is The Key, which is Hayaki Hime. So maybe you guys have a little bit more insight as to what this could mean, but kind of understanding the name is the key here. We'll rock with that. Now, number two is pretty obvious, and this is what gives a lot of credibility to this, is the Zoroark and Zorua leak, and essentially now we have the reveal, and it's related to two different characters, Zoro and Perona, which is a normal human and a ghost girl, and of course, the reveal of Zoro and Zoroark are normal and ghost types, and also there's kind of the name pun as well with Zoro and Zoroark, so I think a lot of us kind of agreed that this was definitely ahead of the schedule here. This was accurate, and this riddle makes sense in the context of what we have now. Moving to the third one, the Riddler says that this is a new Pokemon, one of the post-game contents, And then there's some speculation. This one we really don't have a ton to go off of because it's a post-game Pokemon. So we think it could be a potential new mythical. It's two hearts, clouds that are interconnected. So we'll just table this one because, again, there's not much we can gather from it, assuming it's a post-game Pokemon. There have been some talks about Lovedisc and maybe even Unknown because of characters potentially being like different alphabetical characters or hieroglyphs or whatever it may be. But again, I think we chalk this up to just a new Pokemon, and down the road when it gets revealed, we'll be able to tie it back to this image. Number four is a very obvious one. It says, the Riddler says, this is a no-brainer, and we can really assume Voltorb Electrode, which aligns with some of the other stuff we've seen at this point. So again, nothing too crazy there. Number five apparently says ties to that Lady Noble Pokemon. And we know from the Pokedex or from the Pokemon website that a Raizu has a Noble Pokemon and it's a Lady Pokemon. So unfortunately, that's all we've gathered from this, but I think that maybe we'll be able to make that connection between number five and what the Lady Noble Pokemon is for a Raizu and how that all ties together. But now we're gonna start to get into some of the good stuff because I think we have some really good understanding of what these Riddlers might mean or the Riddlers might mean as we move forward here. So number six is Katori. Asian fans will know what it was immediately. So that's what the Riddler says. Same characters as Little Bird. So this is apparently in Japanese culture, there's a lot of relationships between this character from this anime and Rowlet. And there's a lot of fan art, obviously the color scheme between the hair and the bow, or kind of the hair tie or whatever, ties to Rowlet. So there's a lot of fan art in that culture tying Rowlet and this character together. So this is most likely hinting at a fighting type Rowlet evolution, right? You've got the little head, Katori head, with with the fighting type body on it, and that lines up with what Ball Guy Leaks is saying as well, in the context that Decidueye is going to get a new form, which is grass and fighting type. So I think that one's a pretty obvious one. Now moving to number seven, they said kanji on the pick is key. That's what the Riddler says. Only the Japanese will get it when the Pokemon gets revealed. So when we look at the kanji and we kind of break that down, the cactus is called Sabotender in Japanese, which is derived from the word sabo, cactus, and pretender. So there's a lot of thoughts that maybe because of that and how the kanji is, it actually hints towards a pseudo-wudo line variant, which actually is very interesting because that ties into what Ball Guy Leaks was saying about the fact that one of the baby Pokemon is gonna get a new line or new forms, and Bonsly is actually a baby Pokemon that evolves into pseudo-wudo. So again, there's some kind of jumping and mental gymnastics we have to play here, but when we think about it, I don't think this is necessarily related to a cactus, but rather it's related to the pretender aspect of it, which is that, you know, pseudo-wudo is obviously the fake wood, right? Which is the pretender aspect. He's pretending to be a tree. And again, tying directly into the idea that we're waiting to see if there's a new baby Pokemon line, and Bonsly happens to fall right into that. So number seven is very much so likely pointing towards a new pseudo-wudo line or evolution. Number eight is very, very interesting. We've got this metal snail ring, and the Riddler actually says, this is a new variant. You can tell the type from this riddle. So this is a new variant, the type. Well, let me tell you, it's a ring. It looks like it's metal. So there's a pretty obvious link to steel type here. Then the question is, what is gonna be steel type? What are the various snail Pokemon that are in the game that would tie to this? Well, the first one that comes to mind is Dunsparce. I think a lot of people would agree with that. Magcargo and Slugma's line. You could also maybe throw Centiscorch in there, but I think that's way more of a stretch. And last but not least, and maybe one of the most likely contenders would be the Goodra line. So would we potentially see a Hisuian Dunsparce, Hisuian Goodra, Goomy line, or maybe again, Magcargo and Slugma? But ultimately, if we get a steel type Hisuian slug snail Pokemon, you know this thing was right. You know what I'm saying? Moving to number nine, this is probably the hardest one to decipher. A Japanese pun, when you solve it, you know the type of one starter. So this moon and the moth is 100% tying to a Japanese, or one of the starters rather. And there's a few ways to break this down. I had read some posts about it. The pun is likely, I love you, the moon is beautiful, which has the characters for moon slash moth and beautiful and dazzling. So they kind of took what the pun they think is, and then they put it into Japanese or characters, and then ultimately deciphered that the characters also make up these different words. And then they concluded that the words beautiful and dazzling tied to a potential type, which is fairy type. Further, we've also seen this state that the moonlight and the moth read as gecko and ga, meaning Greninja. So there's a thought that maybe this actually is referencing Greninja and the fact that Greninja's typing is water and dark, and that we're expecting Samurott's typing to be water and dark as well, the Hisuian Samurott line, which again aligns with what we've seen from Ball Guy League. So I think number 9 can tie into two different possible things right now based on the theories and kind of discussions I've seen online. Could it be about a fairy type, or could it be about a dark type? I think the dark type, the second option, is most likely, because again, that does seem to align with what we've seen before. And I don't know if I can envision a fairy Samurott personally, but I guess we'll find out. And it does seem as though it does tie to the Samurott line, the water line. And I buy into the Greninja aspect, of course. Number 10 here. I think first glance, this big ice barge, you immediately assume Avalug. But, you know, the Riddler comes out and says the poke was based on this thing visually. So it's based on this visually. And you think about it and you go, okay, well, it's this big barge, kind of like, you know, an army, you know, landing thing on an iceberg. So again, Avalug is the first thing that comes to mind. But I've seen some thoughts about a potential Mantine form because of Remoraid and the fact that it kind of carries these different Remoraids. So I think there's some value to be said about Avalug, clearly. But I think we could also bring in Mantine into this discussion here as a potential Pokemon that carries things as it kind of glides through the water. So it's a visual representation. It's based on this thing. Moving on to number 11. This is a very interesting one that says the Japanese manga, what happened to her is the key. You must have seen it way earlier than you ever noticed. Esper Mommy. So that was what the Riddler said. It's a Japanese manga. What happened to her is key. You must have seen it way earlier than you noticed. Esper Mommy from the 70s, she has a slash on her neck. This could be related to a psychic and fighting Sneasel variant line. The manga is also about a Japanese yokai. The snake is based on the Kamitachi, so perhaps that's the link. The Chinese Riddler also linked the fan art of Hisuian Weevil as the Pokemon climbing. So, a couple things I want to mention. The Riddler had made a post of a fan art of Hisuian Weavile recently, right? And they seemed intrigued by this artwork. Then going back, we talk about the slash on her neck and the thought that we've seen it earlier than we may have ever noticed, which goes back to the fact that the climbing Pokemon was leaked back in like January, February, and we still don't know what that is. So there's a lot of thoughts that this ties to Sneasel, which is like the slashing Pokemon, and her neck is slashed. And we'll have to wait and see, but it seems as though that's kind of the accepted theory or thought right now, is that this is actually a hint towards Hisuian Weavile or Hisuian Sneasel. We'll have to see what happens with that. And last and not least is this bear that says, you knew what it was from the thief. And that's what the Riddler is referring to, saying Sentro already told you what this is. And Sentro referred to the fact that there is an Ursaring evolution coming. There's also some thoughts that there could be a Spinda variant, but the overall thought is that it is an Ursaring evolution right now, which is a little weird because Ursaring was shown in the trailer as an alpha Pokemon, but I guess it's not like out of the question that they could do something bigger than that, especially if that's an earlier game encounter. So we'll have to wait and see what happens with that. But a lot of insight here and a lot of questions still left unanswered, but I think we're a little bit closer to solving the Chinese Riddler's riddles. If you have anything to add or any thoughts or discussions or anything like that, feel free to leave them in the comments section below. A lot to be excited about, because I think that a lot of this is probably gonna become true. We've already seen Zora and Zoroark number 2 come to fruition, and there's a lot of multiple sources reporting on similar things saying we're gonna get the Hisuian Voltorb Electrode. Now we have the links between the potential baby Pokemon, the Bonsly line, and the cactus, and the potential fake pretender cactus. A lot of interesting stuff that got leaked on the internet last night, or rumored on the internet last night through the Chinese Riddler. So I hope you guys enjoyed this one. Be sure to like the video if you guys did, subscribe to the channel if you guys are new, and let me know your thoughts in the comment section below. My name is Dan, I also go by A-Drive, and I will see you guys on the next one. Peace. We'll be right back.